It is February the 10th, 2023. It is Black History Month and a few days before the Super Bowl. I am Prophetess Brenda Saw Jesus, and I'm honored to fight and serve on behalf of God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit in these last days. God can set it off in this mother. I'm praying for the people of Turkey and the Syrian earthquake. My heart is there with you, and babies, I'm hugging each of you individually as I tell you that God wants repentance. These are some serious times, and that brings me to my subject today. Why do some preachers call themselves prophets? Numbers 12:6, he said, "Listen to my words. When there is a prophet among you, I, the Lord, reveal myself to them in visions, and I speak to them in dreams." And look, there's no shortcuts. It's still that way today. Me personally, now I know that I am rare. Back in the day when I first saw Jesus, no social media, I wanted to express the rareness of what I was going through and what I saw. I felt like a mermaid. That was like the closest thing I could think of at that time. I wrote a screenplay and I called it Harmony, and she was a black mermaid. And there is no prophecy involved in that, but it was like a magical thing. Times have gotten too crucial to be plain. I want the people of all nations to understand that a preacher studies the Bible, learns it, and preaches the word of God to their congregation, and lots more. And a prophet audibly hears the voice of God in dreams, see visions, and Jesus are in some of the visions. So we see Jesus a lot. We preach repentance. I'm not saying that God will not make a preacher into a prophet. It's just not an automatic thing. Like, since you're a preacher, now you're a prophet. Nah, man, don't mislead the people that way. That's how other cult leaders get started. Some of you start out in your purest forms. You come in with a passion to do God's will. You see a void in the world and you want to turn hearts around. People depend on you, call on you, boost your ego, fill your pockets. You are so high up and it still feels like you are starving deep down inside. And the hunger is not food, it's a hunger for power. Somewhere down the line, you develop a God complex. You know you can't be God, you can't be Jesus, you can't be the Holy Spirit, so you lie about being a prophet. You claim to hear God speaking, Lord be offended. You crave the visions and you risk your place in heaven to seek the admiration of people on earth. Preachers, be careful calling yourselves a prophet. Y'all read the Bible and you know darn well what it says about if you're pretending to be something that you're not. My point is that there will be no excuses for you. Being a preacher is honorable right there within itself. And each person suffers, but you have not suffered the excruciating pain that is required in becoming. That's what I will tell you. But you have not suffered yet the kind of excruciating pain that is required in becoming. You see me crying sometimes, compare me to a Bible story, that's fine, but you think you know, but preachers, you have no idea the pain involved for the people in the Bible or me. You see a little chosen but disrespected black girl and you think you can emulate her gifts. Another difference between you and I is that you are loved by your flock. Me, I'm hated and don't give a. I have to become a rebel and willing to walk alone. I only care about pleasing God. Only he knows my capabilities. You don't know the half. Be content with who God called you to be. Play your role. Each role is important. Don't try to be me. It's not a game. God finna see who is really here for him. Also check season 4, episode 21. Just because you prophesy, that does not mean that you're a prophet. Thank you for listening.
Brenda warns that we are living in the last days. Now is the time for repentance. In her visions, she has seen Judgment Day and the rapture. There is life after death, and all people will bow down before the Lord Jesus and confess. The world is gone. It is your soul that Jesus is still willing to save. Jesus is watching. Are you ready? All are welcome to join Prophetess Brenda Saul Jesus on her online prophetic ministries. Her blog is brendasauljesus.blogspot.com. Find her on Facebook, facebook.com/realprophetess. On Twitter, Brenda Saul Jesus. And on Instagram, Prophetess Brenda Saul Jesus. See you there.